What up, y'all? This is Jason Almy
and Christina Alm
from Shit Happens When You Party Naked.
Pinchy motherfuckers.
I don't think that's how you say it.
Pinche.
Something like that.
STFU nerd.
I can't even believe I let you talk to me like that. Everybody can hear this. We're on a hood diner right now trying to do a bumper. Why are you talking to me like that?
Get some dude wipes, you stinky bitches.
I'm just going to let you do this.
What's poppin', Kaz? This pussy, LOL. Keep listening to the hood diner, y'all stinky bitches.
Only on the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Circles up, cabrón.
You are now listening to the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Network.
Shout out to this fucking newer fucking Amazon stretchy scissor hand fucking things, huh? These motherfuckers have definitely earned their fucking... They've definitely earned their pay. Or their worth, I guess you could say.
I still want to get the tabletop ones. The one that's like...
You know, the only thing that I don't like about those is if people start hitting the table... Are you talking about the one that, like, goes into the table but still has, like, a scissor arm that comes out? Or the one that's just a base on the table?
No, it's the base.
And see, that's... Oh, and anytime anything happens...
Think about the table.
Think if we're all on fucking bases and somebody's like, oh!
Bung, 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 exactly.
Then it's just the mics are picking it up and everything like that. I like this right here. I like this because it's, like, it's at the edges of the table. I think it, like, kind of...
Yeah.
It definitely helps. But we need to get you a new... you don't even need... You've adapted. You've adapted like the giraffe.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like...
Nothing funnier than seeing a giraffe fight.
The fuck... Yes.
That's literally the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Two tall-ass diakas going at each other.
We always have a giraffe reference. We talk about that before, but... We have talked about that.
Just ka-clunk, ka-clunk.
Yo, I was like super vulgar in the chat today.
That's all right though. They forgive you.
No one even put LOL.
I should have. I feel like I should have swooped in as your homie, because that's what homies do. But I was kind of like, whoa. Yeah, because you showed me that. You showed me that like one time before we recorded and shit. And even I was like, whoa, goddamn, that's crazy. But no, that was funny. I mean, hey, you know what? That's your...
I'm a vulgar person.
That's your humor.
Yes, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? If people can't handle you, then...
If I'm too much, I need anybody that gets offended in that chat to tell me to get out, and I will.
Yeah. You just exit.
Yeah, it's no big deal.
And that's the thing is, we can't kick you out. You have to kick yourself out.
Well, I'm nasty, so that's just a...
Or no, you know what? Yeah, you can kick people out, I think.
That's just a forewarning, you know? Yeah. I'm going to be, like... Two more nasty because I think that was overboard.
Nah, you're good. You know the thing is like everybody's very reserved in there sometimes.
I'm not. I'm not.
You know what I mean? Because it's a lot of us in there now. You know
these people
saying?
Know who DJ Century is now, like the real him. Like if they had any wonder who the fuck he was,
they're like,
they have a fucking clear view who I am.
So that welcome, God damn it, welcome.
Order up, order up.
This is a certified hood classic.
Like we always do about this time.
You are now tuned into the Hood Diner Podcast with your hosts, DJ Sentry and the homie Casual.
I could have a little bit of that all fucked up, because, you know, I'd be writing this shit down all lit.
DJ Century.
I am the homie Casual.
You're listening to the Hood Diner Podcast, episode 126.
126.
A little break.
Yeah, no.
Breaky break.
Hey, it was necessary.
Achy breaky heart.
At least from my front. I've been telling you that like these past couple weeks, like, you know, shout out to the clients, man, because I've just been busy. I've just been, you know, working, trying to pump out shit, so... I had to take it. You know what it was? It was that Wednesday. And like I had like a certain stack of shit that I needed to have done within the next 2 days, that just the thought of adding the podcast and another something new to it kind of started giving me anxiety.
I hear you.
So I was like,
hey, sometimes you need to just like,
yeah,
put it down on the table and then just back away from it for a little bit.
Yeah, you know? No, it was cool. And it totally helped. Totally helped. Jammed out. Got a lot of shit done this past week. So yeah, we're golden. Got a lot of shit done. Picked up more work too. This shit has been crazy.
It's a good thing.
It's been a good thing, bro. It's been a good thing. The photos has been kind of picking up a lot. Senior portraits. And then I was telling you, me and Tommy Will did this wedding this weekend. That was fun.
Okay.
That was fun, man. I had a really good time doing that shit. And I think he did too. And like we actually got like a couple more like in the works and shit. So but yeah, it was fun. Had a senior portrait this morning. First time I'd ever been to the Tucson Botanical Gardens today.
I've been there for a wedding once.
That's the one off of like Grand Alvernon.
Yeah. Right?
That one? Dude, that place.
You can't drink there, though.
Pretty dope, though. I don't know if the alcohol, I don't know.
I'm going to be real with you, dog. If I jump off the cliff and get married, I'm going to get trashed.
Yeah. Like,
my wife's probably going to be pissed the next day. Night? Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's how you're starting that marriage off right there?
Bro. I can operate sloppy, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'll be real with you. It's more of smoking than anything.
Yeah.
But
I got faded on my wedding day.
Yeah.
I got pretty faded. It was fun. It was crazy. It was the end of the night where I got real faded. Because like by that time, I was less stressed out. I was like, oh, shit. Like everything's done. Everything is done.
But like, you were in love. So, I mean, I don't see it as being like a change. I think it only strengthens the change.
Yeah.
Like all the anxiety of the subtleties of like, oh, can we do it? Will we do it? Issue yeah. the one for me. It's done already. You guys yeah. signed the papers. You went through the ceremonies. Like, you guys are married, you know? Yeah. Yeah. So for me, that's like, all right, now you're the teammate for real.
Yeah, right.
Like,
yeah.
Now your positives are my positives and my negatives are your negatives now and vice versa, you know?
Yeah.
So like, I don't know. I think that once you get to that marriage point, it's kind of like, it should be like, I don't know. I see it as a non-worrying thing.
Yeah.
But
I don't, you know, I always bring up the stress, dude, because like, and have you heard the story about my wedding by any chance like that? Dude, like, okay, we got married in St. Thomas in the fucking Virgin Islands and shit off of a carnival cruise, right? My lady planned like all this shit and we got married in a church in St. Thomas, okay? She planned this shit miles the fuck away. Mind you, we were also getting married in a Catholic church, so we had to do this. We had to do like our, what do you call it? We had to make sure we had all of our things, like our first Holy Communion. And there's one after that. I can never fucking remember the name of it. And then there's something else you had to have. And you, yeah, something like confirmation, I think. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, right?
Oh, you weren't confirmed?
I wasn't. We had to take, neither was my lady, so we had to take these classes right here at St. John's.
Sin.
Which is dope, bro, because that's where I was baptized. That's where I had my first Holy Communion.
You're a sinner, Cass.
And then we found those classes, and it just so happened to be at the same exact church, bro.
That's tight.
Shout out to St. John's right here on the corner of Ajo and 12th. You know
what I mean? That church, like...
It's a beautiful church.
It scarred me, though, man.
It's a beautiful church right
there. I went to school there.
Yeah.
And the way of fucking operating was just different to me. Like, I came from some hood schools, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I go into a privatized school with like Catholic rules and stuff, and I'm Catholic, so it made sense.
Yeah.
I couldn't be there more than a semester. I had to get the fuck out of there.
Right? Every time you walked in, your hair just started fucking smoke.
Oh, bro. I felt like, yeah, the temperature started rising.
You're like,
dude. I'm devout, you know, there's no standard to uphold. You don't have to be Ned Flanders. You know what I'm saying?
But you understand, because you want, so you understand the whole shit. And
yeah,
it's like,
yeah, yeah.
So you have to have all that to get married inside the Catholic church.
Right.
So we had to get that done and get it into the church where we were getting married at in St. Thomas 6 months before the actual date of the wedding. Right. So we had to get that done. That we fucking made it happen. It was like a little 4-week course. We had to stay the night at this hotel by the airport and do this like marriage retreat type thing, and I slept in this room with like three other dudes, and my lady slept in the other room with this other couple with the women and shit like that, and they put you in like little circles, and they make you go through all kinds of different shit, dude. It was crazy, but it was definitely like, it was worth it. Like, I loved it because we got to experience some shit, you know what I mean, that we never really kind of like sat down and talked about or whatever. But that whole shit had to get done before we set up for this fucking carnival cruise, right? And then what's crazy about that is, like, had that day the weather been so fucked up, so when it happens on cruises, when the weather's so fucked up, the boats can't dock. They can't come into the fucking thing. So you, like, they're like, sorry, it's going to be a day at sea. So you just stay on the boat. You don't get to get off. Right? Had we planned all that shit and that day the fucking weather been fucked up, dude, like, how sad that would have fucking been, right? We had a photographer paid, we had vans rented, we took like 40 some people with us, we had both four people like in our bridesmaids and fucking groomsmen and shit. They took us to the church, got married in the church. It was fucking beautiful ass church, and we actually went and revisited it like 10 years later, a couple years ago. It was fucking awesome. And then from there, the vans took everybody back so that they still had a couple hours to like go hang out in St. Thomas, because it was only like limited. It was like we got there at like, I think like 9 in the morning. You had to be back on the boat by like 5, you know what I mean? So the wedding shit kind of went all the way to almost like 1, you know. But it was cool because they took everybody back so that they could change and then go do their thing. And then the photographer took us to this beach where originally my lady wanted to get married right there on that beach. But the second she found out that it was only like a 10-minute ceremony, she was like, yeah, fuck that. Like, I didn't get fucking, you know, I'm not getting, waiting for 10 minutes of a fucking ceremony. Like, I waited my whole life to get married for 10 minutes and shit. So then that's when she decided to, for us to get married in the fucking church and shit. And she made that shit happen. She planned that whole shit. We had to get up, go to the courthouse there to go sign shit and not see each other, you know what I mean, before the wedding. And it just, dude, it worked out. It couldn't have been more fucking perfect. But yeah, no, it was crazy, dude. It was crazy. I think it was fun. I don't even know how the fuck we landed on that topic. How did we land on that? Hey, dog, you playing Pokemon over there, or you going to podcast? Said,
you asked Kenya, it was like, hey.
Oh, I know that, but why did I
bring I don't know. Why'd you bring it up?
I have no idea.
You just wanted to flex?
I just wanted to flex, I guess.
No, because Rob was talking about if he got married
or not. Oh, okay. Yeah. We were talking about the, like, if it was stressful and shit like that, like, or why you would be drunk, So that's what I told you, like, on my wedding day, I didn't really drink until the fucking end of the night. Like, after I knew everything had fucking worked out and everything was good, I got fucked up, dude. I got fucked up and faded and fucking, yeah, it was fucking crazy. But it was fun. It was a good ass time. But anyway, fucking sponsors.
It's a
Dude wipes are flushable wipes for at home and on the go situations. Go to dudeproducts.com and use code HOOD to get 15% off of your order. Hashtag no mud butt.
Do that like super deep voice, like go
yeah.
Down.
Yeah, ready?
Okay.
Official clone. Clone is a streetwear brand rooted in hip hop and pop culture, producing quality shirts, hats, and accessories. That's official. Doc.
Okay.
Let me do that over.
Official clothing is a streetwear brand rooted in hip hop and pop culture, producing quality shirts, hats, and accessories. Go to official.com, that's OHFISHL.com. Use code HOOD and get 25% off your entire order and get free shipping over $50. Official clothing, live by your own rules.
Okay.
Empire Rolling, the makers of the Bennies. Bennies are a high-end rolling paper created from all-natural ingredients and offer a clean and tobacco-free alternative for blunt light smoking sessions. Go to EmpireRolling.com and use code HOOD and get 10% off your order. That's Empire Rolling, the official rolling paper of the Hood Diner Podcast.
Yo. Sandbox. Sandbox is a monthly subscription that provides you with a 30-day supply of your favorite cologne or perfume. Choose from over 850 brand-name designer fragrances delivered right to your door and get free shipping as well as free returns. Go to Scentbox.com and use code HOOD for 35% off your first month's purchase. Scentbox.com.
Okay.
Last but not least, we are a part of the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Go to innercirclepn.com and get the links to all the shows. Preview all the latest releases from the hashtag No Offense Show, Shit Happens When You Party Naked, Simmons and More, The Plunge, Failing Hollywood, The Untrained Eye, and of course, The Hood Diner. That's innercirclepn.com.
Bought it there. It's called Don Q. Okay. You ever heard of Don Q? When we were in Bacardi come from?
It's Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico. When we were in Puerto Rico, we asked the guy that gave us the tour there and shit. We were like, "What do the people from Puerto Rico drink?" And he was like, "We drink Don Q." He's like, "We're known for fucking Bacardi." He's like, "But if you're from here, we drink Don Q and shit." And I've actually seen the bottles at, what is the one right here on fucking Drexel and Bilby and shit.
Liquor
like
Dance.
Liquor Dance.
We were there today.
I've seen Don Q there. You can get some. Dude, whenever you want to splurge on some rum, get a bottle of Don Q, bro.
I want to get a thought bottle.
Yes. A thought bottle?
Those little Cruz Azul, the ones with the bells on the top. Bing, 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 bing.
Okay.
You've seen those tequilas?
I've seen those, yeah.
They're like the white porcelain ones with the blue details.
What's the bell about?
Like, it's a thought bottle. It's like, come running when you hit the bell. Bing, 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 bing. That's just like $240, bro.
For one bottle?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
So, I mean, in the club, it's probably running you like four, maybe? Five?
Oh, man. Bro, this fucking Snapple. It's the 420 episode, guys. 421.
Smoke weed every day.
It's the day after.
You know, I didn't post anything on social media about 420. It's just, I had been smoking.
Dude, because 420 is every day.
It's every day, bro. Like, it was like,
real stoners know what the fuck it is. It's like everybody who wants to get, you know, Taco Tuesday on Cinco de Mayo. You know
what I mean? I actually wanted to not smoke in observance of 420.
You were like, we real stoners take it off.
You know,
real
stoners that's take the day. Yeah, off. Yeah. You just hang out. You know,
that's the day we just sit back and fucking.
You go for a run. You go to the gym.
Or you do other drugs.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well,
maybe you do coke that day.
First of all, I don't do drugs.
Yeah. Right.
I do. I have medicine.
Medication. Hope you guys had a good 420 for you that participated.
I mean, I did.
Obviously.
But it wasn't like I needed to.
Obviously.
I heard those dispensaries were crazy.
Yeah, if you picked 420 to be the day to go to the dispensary, you're either stupid or you know you got like no, you're going for some particular
pretzels.
You're going for some particular special. But you're also not dumb and you probably showed up early. You know what I mean? Like real motherfuckers know. If you just like up and was like, "Hey, you want to get some weed today and celebrate 420? You waited 3 hours at the dispensary, homie. You know what I mean? But nah, dog. We didn't have to do none of that, bro. We linked up with the fucking plug. The client hooked it up. You know what I'm saying? I told you everything that came in this bag right here that I designed for the client. The client took care of me. Welcomed me into the crew, so
the inner
say.
Circle, if you will.
Yeah, if you would.
Inner circle.
If you would. And I shout. Yeah. No, 420 was cool. 421, that's what this one's going to be called. It's going to be called the 421 episode. Because, you know, we're different. We hit a little different.
Smoke that trail mix weed.
What do you mean? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Right? We did a suicide joint.
Or trail mix, either way.
Okay, you
call it trail. Three different strains.
I'd like to call it suicide. But you know what?
Trail mix, there's a lot of different shit in there.
Shout out to the sponsor.
Okay.
I was looking through some shit and I actually found some Benny's.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then the pre-rolled ones. So that's what we were smoking on. You guys are gonna want to check out the Patreon this week. Showed off the new Inner Circle shirt. Looks pretty fly. That'll be up on official.com soon. And so you're crunching the fuck away over there.
Oh,
something
yeah.
new, okay? Let's run through this bitch. First of all.
Yummy.
Kenya came with a gangster-ass fucking Harry Potter donut.
Yeah.
Yeah. And what was it called again?
Butterbeer.
Butterbeer. It was a butterbeer. Butterbeer donut.
I'm butternuts. It's buttercup.
Butter stuff. That horse was a diabetic.
You hungry, girl? Fuck you. Bleep, bleep.
You hungry? Yeah. That fool was a fool, dude. That's still to this day one of my favorite, like, smoke movies. You know what I mean? That's a fun, that's a good-ass movie.
I love when he fucking, he questions a guy about killer.
And yeah, he's like, yo, the guy, did you kill my dog?
He's like, I don't know, bro.
I believe him, yo. I don't know why, but I do. Yo, the guy, did you kill my dog? I believe him, yo. I don't know why, but I do.
That's the best part, dude.
Yes, that is one of the best parts right there. That fucking dude, bro. Oh, man. Okay, something new. The butter beer donut was awesome. I want to try that damn grilled cheese on a donut that you made for fucking Century. It was like last week, right? Mm-hmm. Tell me about that motherfucker, bro. What was it?
It was good.
What was it?
Two donuts. It was grilled cheese. But it was sugared.
Okay, was it one donut cut in half or was it two donuts put together?
Two donuts.
Okay.
Together. But we carved the outside and inside, so you're basically getting the soft middle.
Ah, that's why it looked like it was a donut cut in half. Yeah. Okay, so that. Dude, that's gangster as fuck. Yeah. And then plus you kind of like grill it and then it gets to get inside that right there instead of on the outside.
We butter it up really.
So it was good?
Yeah.
It was good. What kind of cheese was in it?
American.
So there's Havarti and American.
Fuck yeah. Havarti and American.
Yeah, Havarti and American. And we grill it and then we have other grilled cheese too. So you can do like
avocado. And you can get them on donuts?
Yeah. So they come on the large donut ring.
Can you, I don't even know exactly where it's at, right? But do you guys have like, you don't have like a drive-up window, right? Obviously, no. And there's not like any.
Why am I in Saigon?
Can you order something and like they'll bring it out to you or something like that? Is there like an app?
Yeah, so we can do Grubhub and DoorDash.
Okay.
We don't do Postmates right now.
Okay.
Okay.
And then you can order through the Square.
Okay.
Okay.
Check that out. I'm gonna come down. You know what it is? It's just about going downtown. It's like fucking having to park somewhere.
I love downtown.
You have to judge where exactly.
Bro, I whip my fucking Jeep. Ask Kenya.
But I mean, do you pull up at like the little where you got to put coin spots, like where you actually get a good spot?
No, Or
do you pick one of the fucking structures?
I get in where I fit in, bro.
Yeah.
Bro, the other day we went to fucking Panda. They didn't have shit, so I reversed the whole way back. In the Jeep at in night, high as fuck.
Okay,
so yeah, I whipped that bitch. And I knew you put in a four wheel drive. See how I fucking move with them, all them wheels going.
I feel like a Jeep you can fucking just maneuver
for sure,
like a motherfucker. I did a photo shoot this morning and I pulled up at Chipotle, right? I haven't been eating meat. Okay.
Oh, that's where it's on Speedway, that old Boston Market.
Okay.
It's a Chipotle.
Well, you're like, okay.
I did a photo shoot this morning. Okay. And then I wanted to get something to eat on the way back, but I haven't been eating meat.
What?
Me and my lady, we decided we're gonna do like, I think we said we were gonna do like 40 days, no meat at all, no soda, no fast food, right? Oh, dude, like I'm like 8 days or a week and a half in. I already feel like better. You know what I mean? We've been doing like fish. We've been doing shrimp, ceviche, fucking just a lot of vegetable shit. You know what I mean? Like it's been good. So on the way home, I wanted to go to Chipotle because they have those things called sofritas.
Yeah, tofu.
Which is tofu.
Yeah.
But it's cooked in like the type of shit that they cook like the carnitas shit, in and all that shit. Yeah, dude. So it's good, right? I pull up. I'm walking up to the door. It's like 10 fucking 39. I fucking pull the handle and it's not open. I look at the thing. So they open at 10:45. What a weird ass time to fucking open up, right? But while I'm standing there, this ill ass fucking black Jeep pulled up, dude. And this fool, it was lifted on some nice ass rim, bro. Like, honestly, made me want a fucking Jeep just seeing this dude Jeep. I was like, That Jeep was fucking hard right there.
I can see you pushing just, a four-door.
He fucking pulled it. Dude, it was a four-door, bro. It was. It looked clean, bro.
So peep this. This year, they came out with the electric Jeep. Remember we're talking about it?
Yep.
I feel like when I'm done paying mine off, that one goes to the kid, and then I go get me an electric one.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
I mean, I still got 4 years, but.
No, that's perfect, man. She ain't gonna be driving for another, what, seven, eight, six.
Shit.
What did she just turn, nine?
Nine?
Yeah,
nine
so, years. So six.
No, no, she's seven. She's seven.
Well, she's seven. Okay, then eight. She gotta be 15 and a half, right, to get a permit.
I mean, she can get her license, but I don't know if she can be driving.
This has been the longest something new. We got past the donut. Okay, once again, man. Once again, you know what it is. That's what it was. I wanted because my lady is my son, my show love because she's the one that went and picked this shit up.
Yeah.
Right.
Shout out to your wifey.
She was at the store and she was like, "Hey, do you need anything?" I was like, "Duh, we're doing those 420 something new. Get some munchies. You know what I mean?" So there was some new flavors of Twinkies because you know Twinkie is one of them high ass munchies, right? Okay. These are like some new spring flavors. Okay, the first one was lemonade stand. Which I thought was going to be weird, but then it just turned out to taste like a lemon cake, like a lemon bar type of cake. And then cotton candy was the other flavor. And the cotton candy, well, it was good. It was definitely good. You said you liked the cotton candy more.
I gave it a four. I gave the other one a three.
Yeah, I gave them both like fours, I think. But the lemon one was good. I actually liked the lemon one a little bit more than the cotton candy. And then a couple weeks ago, we tried these Dorito 3Ds, but today we got the nacho cheese one, and that's one definitely is better than the ranch one, you know what I mean? I don't know if you want any of these. I'm all putting it on the Lazy Susan, turning them towards you and shit, so you can just get your crunch on. Okay, pass me those things so I can read what the fuck they were. These, we've had these before too, they're called Muddy Buddies.
Well, get them away from me!
Oh, dude, there's so many left in this bag, dude. This bag is legit. But these are Muddy Buddy pretzel bites. They're just definitely like little tiny pretzels, and they're coated with cookies and cream. And I guess there's different flavors because we have had these, but not these tiny like pretzel bites. We had like the regular size ones, which were pretty good. And I think they were just coated in chocolate and shit, and they were good. But yeah, dude, she got that. And then the drink was a Snapple tea, but it's the flavor's called it Takes Two to Mango. I was like, hell yeah, bro. It was, I've never had this flavor. It was good. It was good as fuck. These were definitely five. It was definitely five forks for me. And yeah, man, it was a good something new. We're still getting down over here. I'm going to throw a couple of these.
Yeah, I did five forks on both.
Yeah, these were definitely good.
Or on all three. Because I forgot about the Snapple.
Yep. Yep. But yeah, man.
This was a legit something new.
Give me your fucking money!
Yes. Make sure you guys go Patreon.
When they're this good, it makes me feel shitty when like we only bring one or two things, you know?
But you know what? It's different, though. Because sometimes the fact that she saw all this is awesome as shit, but it's not always like that. Because this is like different sides of the store and shit. You know what I mean? It's like, whoa. So that's what I'm saying. That's why I gotta give her props on this shit. But like sometimes, yeah, you don't find all kinds of new shit at one time. But I, you know what the thing is I feel like when I do go to the stores, I try to get like something to munch on and like something to drink. You know what I mean? Something to wash it down and shit. I know we always got water on deck, but it's always nice to have a little something, a little flavor shit. And then like I said, yeah, that's the other thing. I haven't had a soda in over a week and a half and shit too. And I'm like, almost gave in the other day. I was like, motherfucker, I went to QT, but I got some iced tea. So, yeah, man. Okay, something new. Let's see, the menu tonight, huh? That's some shit. First, they found the cop, that Chauvin dude, they found him guilty, right? On all three counts. They still gotta try the other dudes, right? All the other guys?
So far, I don't know if they took plea agreements or what.
Okay.
But you would assume those three other gentlemen, are going to face some type of
something trial probably less.
Yeah, like they're going to get some type of counts. Like they're going to have to go to court for something.
Yeah,
you can't be an accessory to murder and not fucking
get something.
Yeah, slap on the wrist at least.
Everybody's all fucking telling on the same dude. It was him.
Lifetime probation.
He did it.
You know?
Yeah.
There's people that are on lifetime probation.
Yeah. But yeah, regardless, glad they found that motherfucker guilty, man. They need to make an example of him and start doing more of that. Okay. The Johnson & Johnson shot, bro. That shit got fucking like, you didn't get that one, right?
Hell no.
You got the Moderna?
I'm thinking Moderna.
Full of Pfizer's.
My sister got the Pfizer today.
Okay.
She got that top shelf.
Is that the top shelf?
That's that Primo, yeah.
Is that the one that's only one shot?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And it's the most effective.
Okay.
So.
Telling you, man. I just hope that like fucking 8 years down the road, you hear that fucking commercial late at night. Did you get the Pfizer shot in 2021?
Hey, bro. Are we honest with you?
If so.
My biggest goal is to get my kid graduated from college, and after that, I could die after that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because at that point, she can take care of herself.
Yeah.
That was my whole thought process behind getting the vaccination.
Yeah.
Is making sure I can make her self-sustainable, and then I've done my job as a human being.
Yeah.
As a person on this earth, you know?
I get it.
I don't know. So that's why the whole ideology of just having that vaccination would be useful. I don't know if I was one of those small percentages that would fucking croak if I got it, you know?
Are motherfuckers croaking?
Well, no. As far as coronavirus.
Okay. Oh, no. I thought you were talking about when you get the shot.
No.
Okay.
But
you scared me for a second.
No, like when you get coronavirus, some people die.
Yeah, no, obviously, man. Like it can be fucked up. Look at my cousin. Still down to go see Mortal Kombat movie Friday. I just want to be like, Bro,
it's on HBO.
It's on HBO Max, dog. I don't even got to go nowhere. I'll just tell him, just come to the house, fool, and pay me. I'll make you popcorn and nachos. I'll have some sodas on deck and shit. And fucking,
you can mail him a ticket and shit.
Right? I'll give you points. Pizzas. All that shit. Gummy bears. Milk duds. Oh, man. Nah, you know
I'm
what?
Not looking forward to Space Jam either.
I don't mind going. Space Jam, bro. Dude, I'm going to tell you about the pops. Space Jam pops.
That Martian.
The fucking.
Marvin?
The shirt.
No, the pop.
The shirt one, though, is what I'm telling you.
Okay.
There's a common, and then Target's got the shirt combo. He's metallic. He's the hot shit. Out of all of them, he's the hot shit and Porky. Fool, they haven't even dropped Porky yet. He's going to be a Funko Shop exclusive. Yeah. He's going to be the one that's going to be worth like 60, 80 bucks. He's going to be worth more than the bronze ass. Straight up. Nah, they made some cool ass LeBrons. Amazon got an exclusive.
Are there Monstars?
There's two. Yeah, I think they might drop more later. But there's like a villain and White Mamba. There's a couple other ones and shit like that. But we'll get there. We'll get to Pop Talk. We're going to call it that. We're going to call it Pop Talk. Okay. Moving out of current news into music. Okay, man.
It was so, right. We were wrong on the podcast, right? About DMX.
No. Listen. When we finished that podcast that night, it was the first time that they had come out and said that he passed away. And it was like, they said, you know, it wasn't true. That night that we recorded that podcast, the fucking lawyer had come out saying, no, I was wrong. He's still on life support, blah, blah, blah. And then the day after they announced him fucking dead.
And then Black Rob died.
I was going to write something. I was going to like record something extra into it and shit, dude. But I was just like, you know what? No, I got
something funny for you, though.
We'll just address it. Like, on this podcast and shit. Obviously, man, it's RIP to fucking DMX.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, this one fucked with me, too. That day, I couldn't get shit done. I was like fucking just watching some shit, just like being like, damn. It's crazy how people can affect you. Somebody you don't fucking know. And I get how people come at you. They're like, you didn't even fucking know him, bro.
Yeah, nah, bro.
You didn't even fucking ever met him, bro.
Fuck you.
Fuck out of here with that
the
shit, man.
The biggest difference
if you,
is this, bro.
If you have...
His music gets you through a lot of hard places.
Sure the fuck does.
You know, for me, you know, Deftones White Pony was that. With that being said, you know, fucking DMX has reached so many people, bro. You know?
That fool has sermons. So my, that fool made people proud to fucking, like, pray and shit, man.
I had a little DMX set on Saturday. Not this Saturday, but the previous Saturday when he passed.
Okay.
And she caught my asshole friend drunk in the club doing dog barks when I was doing my DMX set. I want the people to hear it.
That's a lot. Oh man.
That's Joe. That's okay. The homie Joe. He's a fool. I know, man.
Joe.
But
fucking oh man.
Yeah, dude, it's sad, man.
That one fucked, yeah, dude. And the same and then yeah, bro, Black Rob, dog. Like, what the fuck? That shit fucking yeah, that one fucked with me too.
Your mans ain't Rob.
Yeah, dude.
CEO ain't whoa.
Right.
Fuck with me, you get the G.I. Joe.
Yeah. Yeah, no. I had a couple good Black Rob joints that I fucking have loved and shit. There was one he did with G-Dev back in the day.
I like this one that was Despacio.
It's my Despacio. Yes,
yeah,
dude.
That shit was hard.
Yeah.
Winner.
There was this one. I can't remember who. I want to say fucking Mace was on it. And fuck, I think even Faith Evans, maybe something like that. He had a good amount of fucking bangers, bro. That I can't remember the name of that fucking album, but like every fucking beat on that album was dope as fuck. There was a few where I didn't fuck with the song themselves. But that fool reminded me like how a Rick Ross fucking album is. Like the beats are banging and shit. And like, you know, you judge from there whether you like the flows on them and shit. But
it's a pineapple kisses.
Yeah.
With Cool Whip in a Rolls Royce. That's fucking Rick Ross right there. My bitch named Peaches because she tastes like peaches. Like, bro, what are you even saying? Like, you know? I don't know. Is it just me?
No,
is
bro,
it just me?
No, dude. He says some wild out shit, bro. But you know what? I'm telling you, we talked about this before. You cannot deny the fact that Rick Ross doesn't get some of just the illest fucking.
He's an entertainer.
He's an entertainer. The beats that he chooses, bro, are usually just god damn.
So back in the day when we used to give our fucking computers AIDS, downloading off of LimeWire,
FrostWire,
I used to fucking download all the instrumentals and acapellas and shit. In fact, I got to get a hold of my friend that did the same thing, and I think he saved it like on like hard drives. And I will offer him money for those acapellas and instrumentals. Anyways, I thought I was the baddest bitch in the world when I got Black Rob's Woe instrumental.
Yeah.
That fucking violin.
Dun, 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 dun. Yeah. Yeah, dude.
Yeah. Oh, R.I.P. to Black Rob, too.
R.I.P. to Black Rob, man. Fucking. Did you catch the Verzuz?
Which one?
Method Man and Redman.
I wasn't really interested, to be honest with you.
Really? Okay. I caught some of the highlights on Twitter and shit. You were right. I think they fucking at the very end did fucking the Rottweiler, and they still both look like they're fucking just doing the same shit, just fucking still out there doing their thing, dog. They don't look like they're in their fucking 50s and shit. You know what I mean? Late 40s, whatever they're pushing right now.
I'm waiting for that second season of Wu-Tang to come out on Hulu.
Dude. I've been waiting for that shit. Let me see. Okay, did you happen to see the new rap supergroup Mount Westmore?
No, what the fuck is that?
Okay, Mount Westmore is Snoop Dogg, E-40, Too Short, and Ice Cube.
Wow.
Mount Westmore. I fuck with that. Like, that's like a who's who of who was running like 90s, 2000 shit kind of. You know what I mean?
Bro, I don't
want to. Not Too Short. You definitely underground as fuck during the early fucking 90s up? Shit.
You're going to fucking hear from one of your nephews. Oh, that's my Tata's music soon.
That's okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Give a fuck.
That's Tata's music.
Every single one of those four I just said is still doing their thing, still dropping music, man. Like, they're still just.
Be real with you. I don't want a new Ice Cube record.
You know, I'd still fuck with a new Ice Cube record.
Oh, there's nothing I'm going to find interesting on there.
I bet you find at least one song on the whole album. At least one. He's been doing it for me. Like, if he's still dropping albums, I always find at least one in that whole ass album that I'm like, I rock with that.
I'm going to give it a chance.
You know what I mean?
Don't get me wrong. If he got some banger, I'm going to fucking play that Cobra.
I mean, what producer isn't going to want to get on this album?
I get that, but I don't know, man.
Dre probably going to give them a beat.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? Battle Cat might fucking probably try to, you know what I'm saying?
It's funny. My friend requested, he's like, you know, I know you're going to play some Battle Cat for me.
I saw that, yeah.
Fucking dude pulled up to the club. I was like, so his fiance was like, you're going to come to fucking San Diego and DJ our fucking wedding. I'm like, chill. Okay, I'm down.
When is this?
I don't have no idea.
You're going to need a fucking assistant.
Hey, bro, if you're with it.
No, I'm with it.
Because I'm going to have to rent a U-Haul. So.
A U-Haul?
To take equipment over there?
You don't need a U-Haul. You get a van. Get a van. Just get a big ass van, yeah. We could just fuck. Everybody has like their own fucking bench to sprawl out. Just fucking crash and then somebody drives. Okay. Mount Westmore. I guess they dropped a song on at the fights. The fights where fucking the Jake Paul and them fought at the Triller Fight Club or some shit. Let's see. Let's see what the fuck this is.
What?
It says the Triller Fight Club. It says rap supergroup Mount Westmore premieres new song at Triller Fight Club.
Okay.
Look at them all fucking in like a bunch of different like big ass chairs and shit. Like, we the Dons, motherfuckers. We the Dons.
It's like a fucking like a mafia boss's table.
Right. The single is called Big Subwoofer. Already don't like that. That's a funny ass name. Big Subwoofer. Where the fuck is the video? Okay, here we go. Let's see what we got here. This is it. Okay, I kind of fuck with it. I want to hear 40's verse, dude. 35 seconds left. I don't know if that's...
Maybe 35 seconds too much.
Okay. I think he just got up. I think 40 goes next.
I still fuck with 40 heavy, though.
Nope, they just got up because they're doing the hook. Let me rewind it a little bit. Here's 40. Okay, there he is.
It's a party when I pull up. And he crawled in the trees and you see me. Got my do you want me to stop anything? My weapon. Anything I want, I can afford.
Listen.
Never hustle backwards, always forward.
Progression.
I can multitask, always on the grind. I can walk at your gut at the same time. I ain't on my heat, I ain't missing an act. I'm the center of attention, bitch, the main attraction. When I enter the turf, when I pull up, what happened?
I mean, he's not really fucking like doing it for me right now, but I mean, it sounds dope. It sounds dope. I'm gonna have to go check out like the song itself, like on the way home. I'm gonna find it on fucking Apple. Let me see if they have it. Let's see. Big sub woofer. Nope. Oh, you're going in on them shits, huh? Okay. Nope. Nah, that shit ain't now. I guess that was like a fucking preview then. So, cool. We got to check that shit out. That's a super group. You know, I was going to ask you that too. That was the other thing I had it written down, man. Is like, if you were given the opportunity to put together some sort of a super group.
Oh, man.
Like, think about... But this is the thing, though. Would it be like Dead or Alive? Because that would fucking...
Well, just do a mixture of both.
Okay.
A super group. Now, are we just doing singers? Or are we doing it like...
I think you could do any kind you want. Because I was thinking about that. Like, what if I was to get like Pac, Jimi Hendrix. Like I'm talking about mixing it up like that. Like, that would be dope. Pac, Jimi Hendrix, Sade, and Dr. Dre. That's my super group right there. That's pretty good. I fuck with that. Maybe not. I don't know. Maybe not. It was just real quick.
I'm going to say Niles Rogers.
Who?
From Chic.
Okay.
Daft Punk. Rihanna.
Okay.
Maybe Calvin Harris.
Okay.
I'm just throwing out names right now, and I can refine it.
It's not bad.
Shit, Jay-Z is one of them.
Right.
Like, I mean, it's hard, bro. That question takes too long. But for a short answer, I'll do Niles Rogers for like the composing aspects of it.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe Pharrell as well. For the singing and the beat making.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't even know, man. For a hip hop group, yeah. And then maybe Scarface for singing, like for rapping.
What? Really?
Yeah, man. That down south. He's one of the greatest rappers, bro.
He's definitely up there. Everybody always says, do you agree that he like switched up his style? Like after Ghetto Boys and shit?
Somewhat. I mean, he reinvented himself. Yeah, he went definitely solo, did. You know?
Yeah. You know, I haven't heard shit about him in a while. Remember, he got COVID.
Well, that's right.
Remember, he got COVID and shit, and we never fucking really heard what happened to that. Hopefully, he's good.
Yeah. I have to come back to you on that, bro. That's too hard of a question for me to answer.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Look at since that's like our pick for this week, but refine it, fine-tune it, and we'll talk about it on next week's music shit. So, homework. Okay. I think that's it for music. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I didn't see the Meth Redman versus, but I saw a lot of people tweeting about it, saying that it was good and shit like that. So that's cool. Okay, jams of the week, bro. What you got?
Well, actually, for music.
Okay, what do you got? What do you got?
There was a Lil Durk concert in Phoenix on Saturday last week, and some fucking chick got shot. Lanny from Cobra, he's a bouncer at Cobra. He fucking got asked to help out in Phoenix with the concert. He goes, dude, the fucking Phoenix PD took off after the show started. He goes, some of the security team left too. He goes, there was 12 security guards for that whole concert.
Why? Why did they take off?
I don't know.
That sounds like fucking the plot is about to thicken.
The celebrity theater outside. So they could hold a venue, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, fuck, bro. Like, why would you go to a Lil Durk concert? Like, that's Chicago drill rap. That's like Chief Keef. You know what I'm saying? That type of shit.
Okay.
So with that being said, you know there's going to be drama there.
Yeah.
I think some chick got stabbed. Positive Satan posted something on his Instagram saying some chick got stabbed and shit. Okay. Like a
video. Was he there? Did he go?
He didn't. I don't think he went. Alva was supposed to go. He ended up not going. So actually, shout out to Young Alva. He came through in a big way for me. I got a wedding to go to on Saturday, and he switched me days at Cobra, so I'm going to be spending Friday, and he'll be spending Saturday.
Nice.
So I'm going to see what his Friday nights look like, you know?
Nice.
But
what is that? Is that like an open format, or do they do like a specific ship that night?
I do what I want.
Okay. Open format, then.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah,
whatever. I do what I want.
Yeah, no, it's a good time there. But yeah, shout out to Alva. But yeah, he said he was going to go, and I called him the next day. He didn't answer. Then he called me back the following day, and then he was like, yo, I saw you call. What's up? And I'm like, yeah, just seeing if you were good, bro. I heard they were busting guns over there. Just make sure you didn't get hit, you know?
Right.
But yeah, that's my – and then they have a little boozy going up this week.
Yeah?
They must really want someone to get killed. Oof.
I think people are just, let me see.
They're just, what the fuck?
Let me see. Nah.
Look at him.
Motherfuckers. No, not going for it. As we okay. Go a little something like this. Hit it. Jams of the week, brother.
Okay. Well, you know, I'm a big fan of the Griselda Records label. And Conway the Machine came out with a new project. He has a song with 2 Chainz. It's called 200 Pies.
Okay.
It's pretty dope. I recommend you listen to it. And then my throwback is Black Rob. Whoa.
Okay.
You know, RIP Black Rob.
Definitely. Okay.
¿Y tú?
You know, I've had all the Kendrick Lamar albums. But the other day, when I was cleaning, I had my shit on shuffle, and this song called Real comes up. I was like, I'm real. I'm really, really real. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It's a badass song, bro. Like, I fucking was hyped. Like, it was one of those songs where I was like, dude, I've never heard this song. I've had it in my phone for who knows how fucking long. But jammed out to it, like listened to it like 3-4 times in a row, like while I was clean. I was like, dude, this is some hot shit right here, right?
Oh yeah.
And then the other one, I gotta give a shout out to Deej, the boy Deej, big Deej in the building.
Yeah.
With his untrained eye.
I'll say an untrained eye.
Right? You like that setup? That was me lobbing the fucking volleyball your way, bro. He did this little thing the other day, kind of promoting, we're bringing back this, Inner Circle show called Comedy is Dead, right? And he's been putting like, you know, a couple feelers out for people that we want to get involved in the show to talk about like different shit. It's like this, you know what? You would be fucking great on Comedy is Dead.
Oh, yeah,
I'm signing you up.
Okay.
Because Comedy is Dead is like, you talk about shit that people are not like, they're not supposed to talk about.
Oh, like I have no fucks.
Like give. A no fucks giving shit, but why? Like why you have an opinion on why? Nah, you feel a certain way about this. Oh, you're not allowed to say this. You're not allowed to say this. Well, let me tell you why I feel I can say this or this and that. You know what I mean? Like it's just, it's the truth. It's a truth seminar.
It'll set you free.
Yes. So I'm going to find out when they want to do that shit. Anyways, he had a little thing on fucking the stories or the Inner Circle shit. And he had this song by Slick Rick in the background with him and Outkast. That song is called Street Talking.
Bom, 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 bom,
bom. Yes, dude.
Yep, that's my shit.
I'm you know, the funny story about that. I haven't that. Heard Honest, man. Slick Rick and Outkast so is on this jam.
I go on this this trip as a youth, as a freshman.
Uh-huh.
To go tour different colleges. We go up to GCU, we go up to ASU. I literally go to the student union and find a record store, and I end up buying Slick Rick's album, which is his first album out of jail.
Okay.
Which Street Talking was on that. And they also has another one that I forget the name of it with Outkast.
Street Talking is the one with Outkast.
But there's two of them.
I don't see the other one.
It's on the Stankonia.
Oh, it's not on this album, like that, is what you're saying.
Gonna put the pump right back your back. Yeah,
no, yeah. I thought you meant that it was on this Art of Storytelling album. Because that's the one that he did when he got out of jail.
Yeah, yeah. That one particular. It's two different. Anyways, I bought that CD and bumped it all the way up, all the way back down from Phoenix into Tucson. I was bumping that fucking CD in the bus. And yeah, bro, that's like one of my favorite songs. My favorite hip hop songs.
I hear them though.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Boom. I'm trying to claim things I haven't earned, honest, man. Slick Rick and Outkast is on this jam. But keep diving on the 2-2 grand. Trying to help raise all the youth to me. Skip the ruler, Rick, his face to slam. Help clean up this land. The reputation of this man. We're holding this
down. Did you ever see that movie called The Show?
Yeah.
The documentary?
Yeah.
Remember how Russell Simmons was all, he was really out here calling people pieces of trash. He called them crumbs. He's all, you white poor pieces of trash. Like, he would talk shit, bro.
It was tight because he was very eloquent with his fucking words. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, he was, bro. And he had like a style, bro.
Smooth.
A smooth ass style, dog. Like, he thought he was just fucking, just the baddest motherfucker.
He was the man for a while.
Yeah, bro.
Didn't he shoot his brother-in-law or like attempted murder or some shit?
You know, I really don't know the whole story.
I think that was a thing. I wish you were a hip-hop historian like Pike.
God damn! I mean, I know my shit, but not everything, homie.
You need to fucking step your game up, right?
Okay. Well, I'll keep that in mind.
I'll fucking... Yeah.
Okay. We came, we saw, we kicked it down. We're into movies. Television.
Dude, I'm not looking forward to Mortal Kombat at all.
I mean, I'm gonna fucking watch it.
I am too, but...
From what I've heard, they already got like more movies on deck. Like, they're gonna do more. They're gonna do more of these.
I bet they do.
You know. So, but yeah, my cousin hit me up right now. He's like, "You wanna go see it?" I'm like,
"Nah."
I mean, I don't mind going, but I could watch it at home. Finally, watched Godzilla versus King Kong. It was good.
I didn't really like it. I told you last week.
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
was it great? No.
No, no.
Was it cool that I watched it once and I can say that I've watched
it? Was it something to watch? Yes.
Yes, exactly. Was it something...
Is it going to change your life?
Was it something you're going to go revisit? Probably, maybe, depending on how you like these movies.
If you're in a fucking airplane going to Hawaii...
And that's what's on? Yeah. Like, you're going to watch it.
Yes, yes.
You know? You go to your Diaz house and they're halfway through watching that and they're not going to let you change the channel. You're going to watch it. But if someone's like, hey, you want to watch this or do you want to watch like Falcon and Winter Soldier? You're going to be like, nah, you know, let me do that Falcon Winter Soldier. Speaking of which, are you caught up on all that?
I'm sure as I'm not.
You are not?
I'm left off at episode 2.
Oh, my God.
Isn't that good, though? Because now I have episodes to watch.
Yeah, now you got what? Like 3 now, right? 4, 3, 4, 5?
Yeah, good amount.
Bro. 4.
It gets real.
5.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oof. It's good. It's good. The one I'm not looking forward to, I've already watched the trailer. Fast 9.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck it, 9, bro. Like, I think this franchise is just proof that Hollywood just like, you know, bro, it worked. Let's do it again.
That's
bro,
all that is.
It worked. Let's do it again.
They sex sells for one.
Bring it back.
Sex sells for one.
Yeah.
Fast cars. explosions, Michael Bay, you know, that type of
shit.
It is
the pot of, it is the smorgasbord fucking goulash of everything that's good.
It's literally
the paella of movies.
I think what it is just more eye candy than substance.
It's everything good.
Because I checked out that fast food shit a long time ago.
I mean, just like I said,
I didn't even watch Hobbs and goddamn The Rock.
That was just a fucking shit show right there. It was hilarious, but there was points where you were just like, really, dude?
Come on, man.
It's just total get the fuck out of here moments. You know what I mean? Like, get the fuck out of here. No.
Yeah.
Miss me
with that bullshit.
Okay. Let me see. What have I been watching? I've been watching Beachy Sheldon and fucking... what is it? Big Bang Theory?
Yeah.
Revisited that. Started at the beginning again.
I was never into that show.
I'm gonna tell you what, bro. I laugh my ass off at these.
Hey, I'm not talking shit about
nerds,
it. I just never...
bro. Like, I'm cracking up. It's, you know what? It's because of everything else that we've been watching is over now, or we're already caught up on different shit. So it's like, sometimes we just want to put something on quick. Cause you ever do that? Like, you got some food. You're gonna watch TV, but you wind up spending too much time fucking trying to find something to watch. Next thing you know, your food's cold and you're just pissed, right? Sometimes it's cool to have little shit that you know is going to make you laugh. And fucking for me, that show is one of those shows.
Okay.
Because they crack me up. And then plus, I can dig the fact that they're into some of the nerd shit that I love too. You know what I mean? They love the Comic-Cons. They love like all the fucking, you know, the superhero shit, the anime shit. And fucking, so yeah, man, it's a funny ass show. I fuck with it. Never got into the stupid one that they did about a little kid though, a young Sheldon, whatever the fuck.
Oh,
they
that's
did.
A new one, right?
That's them, him as a little kid and shit. But nah, I didn't go that far. But yeah, Falcon Winter Soldier was sick. Only other thing I got is, did you see by any chance that they're making a sequel to The Hitman's Bodyguard, and it's called The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard? Did you ever see The Hitman's Bodyguard on Netflix? That was, what is his name? Deadpool. What is Puto Deadpool?
Fucking Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds and Samuel L. Jackson.
They have a movie on Netflix?
They have a movie on Netflix called The Hitman's Bodyguard.
Okay.
And he's like a hitman, but he fucked up and did something. So now he's got all kinds of people on him. So he got these bodyguards to kind of get him to a safe place and shit like that, right?
Yeah.
So apparently this is like the other thing, because you know who his wife is? Who Samuel Jackson's wife is? Salma Hayek.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Man.
It got creepy real fast.
Super creepy.
Creepy real fucking
I'm
fast.
I'm kind of disappointed in myself.
Okay, but yeah, there's a trailer up for that. Check it out. I think it's another like straight to Netflix movie. So, okay, moving out of movies and TV into fashion and pop culture.
Oh shit!
The Zion Ones came out.
You have a picture of them?
I don't, but you got internet right
there. How you gonna act mad on vacation? How do you not have a picture of Zion 1 if you're gonna bring it up?
Because there's not really room for photos in here. I want to redo this. I need to redo this kind of the notes type thing. Well, in all reality, I would really love it if we had like a screen. Remember, we usually do have a screen.
Yeah, we're still in the works.
Okay, so like...
I don't like it.
I don't like them either.
I don't like it.
I can see some people liking them.
I mean, if it's a functional shoe, cool. If it's a shoe that you can play hoops in, this looks like a fucking Payless shoe.
It looks like a fucking a broken Achilles waiting to happen.
No. This looks like ankle support. This looks super technical.
Okay.
But the design is ugly. This Z on this fucking shoe is hideous.
Okay.
The color schemes are whack. Ugh. Like somebody threw up on a fucking shoe.
Yuck.
Yeah, that's a no for me, dog.
Okay. And then right now, the Jordan...
Buck 20.
The Jordan 11 Lows, the legendary blue. I kind of like these. You know what? These, to me, I like these just for like some everyday like roll around shoes, but to have something clean. They're like, you know, they're the white those with the clean. Carolina yeah, blue yeah, on the yeah, bottoms yeah. and shit, the icy blue.
Those are bitch to keep clean though.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know what? I'm not walking in dirt shit. You know, I'm on pavements and shit. But you know what? I'm telling you, they have those things now that you can put on the bottom of your shoe.
Little shoe condoms.
Little shoe condoms. Well, not even that. They have the one where it's like a sticker. It's like a clear sticker. So you people can't even tell you got that on your shoe.
You people.
Winner.
It's a sticker. And you put it around the bottom of the shoe and it even comes up the sides and then you can trim it. So it will go all the way up the blue and then it goes over the blue and then you use like a little X-Acto and like trim it around and yeah. shit. You know what I mean? Like you can really form it to the shoe. I saw a dude who has a channel that wore like some shoes and he put that shit on and went out, had a night, danced, all kinds of shit, brought him home, took him right off, nothing. Clean as fuck right there. Ready to resell. Ready for resale.
When fucking got it all full of fucking foot funk.
He wore like
no.
He wore like two pairs of socks and shit.
Still funky.
Nope. Didn't funk nothing up. Mm-mm. Think you put your foot in like a bag, plastic bag. When you're walking around, it's all yeah. But anyway, these Jordan 11s are dropping in a day or so. What's today? They're dropping this Saturday.
Okay.
Last thing with shoes and shit like that. Did you see that the Kobe Nike deal has come to an end?
Yeah, that's wild.
It is pretty crazy.
That fucking resale price is going to go through the fucking roof.
I wonder what his wife is planning on doing. I wonder if either they've been approached by maybe other shoe companies or if they're just going to call it. I don't see them doing that. But what if they're just going to do like their own brand, like literally the Kobe shoe, like a Kobe brand. Like what if like just, you know, some sort of shoemakers are fucking, you know, hitting her up behind the scenes saying like, hey, look, we can do this. Because I saw there was like a letter that she put out saying that I guess that Nike wasn't handling the releases properly and different that. Like there was a couple different reasons why she wanted to end the relationship with Nike. So I could have a little bit of that all fucked up because, you know, I'd be writing this shit down all lit. So, but yeah, the Kobe Nike deal has come to an end. So like, yeah, like you said, getting all the Mamba shoes right now are going to just, I guarantee you the second that happened, eBay fucking prices shot the fuck through the roof, you know?
Yep.
Like what happened when fucking Binchy T'Challa fucking passed away and all the pops fucking went up like within an hour.
Yeah.
Remember I told you that? Like I got it and then I pulled over at my house and I got one and then like 15 minutes later.
Did you ever move those bags?
What bags?
Those Black Panther
bags. You know what fucking? No, I did not.
No?
No. People want them cheap as fuck. I guess there's too much in circulation right now. So I'm just going to have to sit on them, dog. I sold one. I did sell one, but I've had it on Mercari.
Did you get your money back?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, I still got to sell a couple of them. You know what I'm saying?
So you did it then?
Like real shit. Like just between me and you, this is how much I paid for them. I paid pop and I've been trying to sell them for 25.
Oh, okay, so you don't really got a crazy investment.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie. When I first put them up, I put them up for like 50.
Yeah, and you're all boop, boop. Boop.
Even Mercari's like, these are kind of trending at this point. Are you sure you want to go that high? There's a big possibility you're not gonna sell this. And yeah, I put it on my Facebook Marketplace like a hot minute ago, and it's still there chilling. So it's like, that's fine though, bro. I got nothing but time.
Right.
You know, hopefully, but I got nothing but time. But I'm gonna sit on them shits. But you know what? I could probably give them away for presents too, like some of my nephews and shit like that.
Yeah,
I think I'm gonna hook my nephew up with one of them shits. Okay, Funko Pop Talk, bro.
Funko Pop Talk,
bro. I gotta tell you something. Or actually, I kind of did tell you. I think you were the first person I called. I told you about how I got in with some of the Funko homies.
Yeah.
And then they decided to use my newest video, which just so happened to be like a pretty good video. All newer pops, the Pietro, the Flash, like a bunch of new shit. And I did two mystery box unboxings. Like I opened like a grip of shit on this fucking show. I didn't even open up those Target ones that had the black lights in them. I'm saving those so somebody else can open them up, right? But I got that set for sale and shit. But anyways, they chose my thing and they were like, look, this guy only has 50 subscribers, guys. Let's help him get as many as we can. Within an hour, bro, I was sitting at 100 and like three. And then by the end of that night, I was at like 111. Like, that's, I think, where I'm at right now, 111 subscribers. So now, like, I'm just waiting for the little thing to update where I can actually make my YouTube channel an actual channel name instead of it being, you know, youtube.com/05B4759.
Right.
All that shit. I can finally actually put what's popping.
That's right tight. There.
You know what I mean? So the next big milestone is going to be 1,000.
Okay.
Because that's when you can get monetized and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But, I mean, fuck, bro. That's only 9 times more than where I'm at right now, bro. Like, I think it's going to be possible. I just got to keep pumping more videos out, dude. So that's what I'm doing. But, yeah, shout out to her name is Silver-Haired Wolf. She's from, like, Brooklyn, bro. And she's a collector and shit like that. And she gets with different Funko channel dudes. And they all do lives together, bro. Like, dude, that's it makes sense because lives are hours watched, hours earned towards your fucking monetization. Okay. Remember I told you, it's not just about 1,000 subscribers. It's also 4,000 hours of people watching your shit. I thought it was you watching other people's shit. No, it's your shit. People have to watch your shit for 4,000 hours, bro. And you know, the other part has to be within a year span.
So you got to get pretty much a good amount of people watching your content.
But think about this. You do a fucking 2-hour live fucking with a bunch of people and shit. You get a couple hundred, maybe even 1,000 people watching that. That's 1,000 times 2 hours. You're already fucking halfway there.
Yeah.
Feel that right there?
For sure.
See what I'm saying? So it's like, dude, like I totally see where when you have a cool ass little community like that, how it really works, dude, because they didn't have to fucking do that, bro. But they were like, hey, what's popping? Like everybody, let's go do this. And you had to put, it was pretty cool. I figured it out. Like, if we were want to do giveaways and shit, there's like some sort of a website where you put the video link and then you put a hashtag in this thing. And it looks for all the comments that have that hashtag and it rounds up all those people's names. And then when you want to do a random giveaway, you just press a little button and it goes through people's names. Boom, you're the winner. That's and it's tight. Fair. You share it on the screen so people can see that it's fair. Bro, it was cool. So they did like 4 or 5 giveaways during the time that they were getting people to come in there. It was like at like 93. It was like 30 minutes before I needed to go meet Tommy to go do this wedding and shit.
Yeah.
And like, I'm just like, what the fuck? I was like, holy shit, dude, this is fucking crazy, bro. And then, yeah, once they got me over 100, dude, I had to fucking call you. I was like, bro, these motherfucking Funko homies just helped me get over 100 subscribers in less than an hour, bro. My channel's been up for maybe, what, 2 months now?
Yeah.
And I got 50. They got me another 50 within an hour. That's dope right there, bro. You can't ask for any other fucking, like, help like that. Like, that was just awesome, dude. So, yeah, so shout out to them. I went and followed, like, all of them, like, on Instagram, fucking all that shit, going to their videos, going and leaving comments on their shit. Bro, and, like, even just doing that, I've been picking up other subscribers from their channels and shit. So, yeah, dude, that's why they say when you have a very specific niche, it's better that way instead of having, like, this all free-for-all fucking just video channel. Like, these dudes that you watch opening these Pokemon shits, it's crazy to think that they have thousands of fucking followers, but it's because it's what specific. It's very fucking specific. And there's always people that are like, I want to see what this Charizard does. You know what I mean? Like, all this crazy shit that you be telling me about. People wanted to see the fucking Pietro. You know what I'm saying? Like I told you, when you go search Pietro unboxing, mine's the fourth video down. It's fucking dope, bro. It's like,
I'm going to fucking bring up this little price card real quick.
Do it.
So you can see what I'm fucking talking about.
Do it. Meanwhile, I'm going to look at some of these pops that, like, I'm going to show you that are dropping very soon here.
Champion's Path Charizard Shiny, $316.
Okay. A six.
See how the shards are a different color? It's black.
Yeah, that's badass.
It's normally orange.
Okay.
And the under wing is like teal. Well, this one's black with the under wing like maroon.
Okay.
So it's an older card, but it's $316 for like a bent out of shape one. Like not a, this one says.
For just like a like
near
a
mint.
Near mint? Yeah. Near.
So there's money to be made in that shit, bro. Like, and I get it with the pops too.
Bro, the other day, I mean, they have an old one that came out a hot minute ago, but they just announced a brand new fucking Splinter.
I saw that for the teenage shit.
Yeah, I had to share that shit, dude. He looks hard. Fool, he looks fucking crazy. Look at him.
Yeah, that fool's tight. You know, I saw the telly that you pre-ordered. They should do a chase where the eyes are red.
Bro, they missed a total opportunity. Some other homie said that too.
You know?
He was like, oh no, it was fucking Joe B. Shout out to Joe B. Joe B was like, why didn't they make the chase with red eyes? That was fucking perfect.
Smoke weed every day.
Babe, you know what? But regardless, shout out to Funko for waiting till 420 to drop that pop. Like, that's badass, dude.
Oh, yeah.
And the fact that he's flocked is dope, dude. So So I grabbed one. But dude,
don't forget to bring a towel.
Bro, he's not coming till like fucking October. Damn. Like by my lady's birthday and shit. It's gonna be crazy. That's how some of these are fucking. I was telling Joe B and them the other day, like they were asking me, they're like, hey bro, have you ever ordered from this place? How long does it take for you to get pops and shit? I'm like, no, I've never ordered from there. I'm like, but bro, when you order pre-orders sometimes, it's like fucking 4, 5, 6 months out. I was like, bro, I got pops showing up right now that I ordered last year.
God damn.
I was like, they're like, bullshit. I'm like, no. Real.
Yeah, real shit.
Those motherfuckers are coming. Let me see. Okay. They dropped him. Did you see? Oh, dude, please tell me you saw the Tapatio, homie.
Yeah, that shit goes hard too.
I sent you the Tapatio, but he's going to be common as fuck, bro.
Okay.
He's common as fuck, so you'll be able to pull one of him like next time you visit like a Hot Topic.
Okay.
Shit like that. Like, he's going to be everywhere. FYE. You could go to any of those right now. Even GameStop has them for sale there. It's super common. Even Walmart's gone. They're everywhere. He's everywhere. Okay. Okay, bro, this was some crazy shit. This dropped the other day. And this is some wild shit. Somebody posted a picture of a black light Venom, Eddie Brock.
Well, let's see it.
Right there.
Wow.
Okay. He's black light, right?
Wow.
The box, everything. There was like a fucking a rumor going around between a lot of the Funko channels. They're like, it's got to be fake. It's fake. Somebody made it fake. But then somebody like actually got it and analyzed it, took pictures of the feet and everything like that. And it proves that it's real, right? So that's why right now, people are tripping on the Carnage one, because on the box of this one, it's him and Carnage right there, the one that came out last year. So everybody's like, holy shit, that's going to drive the fucking Carnage up right there. And the price went up to like 110 right
now. Damn.
Carnage, dog, the Blacklight one. He's the most expensive out of all the Blacklights right now. And so, so that's going to be a Target exclusive. It might be like one of those t-shirt combos, but maybe not. Might just be just regular pop, but I guarantee you, it's going to sell the fuck out, bro. It's going to go fast. That's like the demand right now. The Pietro's already like, they're going to restart Pietro. What's up with this one? I'm ready for Eddie Brock. What's up with that? Like, everybody's like ready to get that motherfucker.
Yeah.
And then we talked about the Space Jam pops. Yeah, they dropped some dope ones. There's a couple of exclusives here and there. But the one that is the fucking bad boy, dog, is going to be the one that comes in the shirt combo. He's metallic. Okay, so like this is him right there. Let me make it a little
bit. That is sick.
Look at him, bro. He's like all shiny and metal and shit like that. It comes in a shirt combo. I'm so sad, dog. Like, Target dropped all of the pops at the same time that everybody did earlier, except for this fucking shirt combo, right? I'm in my room. I'm doing some work. My lady's like, hey, will you help me with some of these weeds in the backyard? I'm like, all right, I'll be right there and shit like that. For the 5 minutes I went outside and then finally took a look at my phone, they dropped that shirt combo.
Sold out.
And it sold out. Shout out to Deej. Deej got one. Deej was able to get himself one. So I told him, like, hey, anybody sees one with a 2X shirt, fucking grab me one. I'm going to get one. You know, the 2X is the best I can do. They don't have a 3X, so the 2X is what I got. It's what I'm going to get. But they're going to be in store. Apparently, they're like, nah, they're going to restock the shit out of those. But that's going to be the one to get, dog. That's going to be the one to get. So if I fucking see one, if you want one, fucking I'll grab two of them and shit.
All right.
Grab two X's. Is that what you rock, a 2X or an XL? Okay, I'll grab you XL. But let me see. There's a couple of LeBron that are pretty cool. But the one that's going to be badass is the Martian and then the Porky Pig, like I told you, because the Porky Pig hasn't released yet. He's going to be a Funko Shop exclusive. Yeah. So, okay. You know, they've been doing crazy shit. It's usually Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays that they do drops. I think I gave that little tidbit away. That's a fucking little piece of information. Set your fucking alarm for like 8:58. And then at 9 o'clock, go to the fucking Funko store and start looking at the newest shit. Cause that's when they do surprise drops. When they just drop shit, when they're like, fuck, it's out there. It's out there. Now, when they do scheduled drops, they come out at 11 a.m. Pacific time.
Okay.
Okay. So like fucking, I have alarms set for both. Like 8:58 and 10:58. And I check and I get ready to fucking see what's cracking because I'm telling you, these motherfuckers are on it, bro. They're fucking on
it. You sleep, you're not going to get it.
Yeah. But it's cool though, man. You know why? Because on all these days now, it's forcing me to fucking get up early and shit. Or earlier, I guess you could say. Earlier.
Yeah.
Okay. And tomorrow is WonderCon. I'm sad I didn't get it chosen, but WonderCon is tomorrow for everybody that got picked. And then the day after for everybody that didn't. So I'm going to try to get that Stormtrooper and the Madam Mim from the Sword and the Stone. And you never know if it's like, if they're not sold out and I can get them directly from Funko, they might send me a con sticker. You know, that's what they did with that Daredevil.
Right.
That I got that one time. They actually had the sticker and I like didn't notice till like 4 minutes in my face and the fucking camera caught all that shit.
Yeah.
That's a good ass little fucking video, man. Love that. And then the last thing is they dropped a new, what is his name? The Coca-Cola can.
Yeah.
They made a cherry Coke. So okay. It says cherry at the top and he's actually holding a cherry. So it leaked out today. It hasn't dropped officially anywhere yet, but yeah, that's all I got for the Funko Pops this week. I think it's June 26th. These will be in stores. Right. At the Targets and shit like that. So I'm going to try. I'll be definitely doing a video. I'm going to try to go there like early and shit. And oh, yeah. Look, this is the video or this is that picture that I was telling you about. This leaked out.
Okay.
But people are saying Funko's getting kind of fucking crafty, bro. People are saying that somebody at the Funko headquarters just grabbed two boxes and set them out there and then let somebody grab them. Or maybe gave them to somebody specifically that they knew would take pictures of that and put it out into the wild and start getting people amped up on that. They're doing fucking shit, bro. They're trying some fucking tactics, bro. It's kind of crazy, but it's also awesome at the same time, dude. It's fucking weird, but I'm all Funko conspiracies and shit, bro. Oh, and then I've been using this, I'm going to tell you about this. Like when you start doing your channel, You got to get this thing called TubeBuddy.
Okay.
Because it looks at your videos and it says, okay, you're using the keywords. Okay. You're using hashtags. Okay. You have a good title, blah, blah, blah. Like it starts telling you like, this is different shit that you should look for. And then when you hit certain milestones, they send you these little things.
Okay.
So you can post them. Like, this is my little 100 subscriber one.
That's tight.
And then this one, it's like you've passed 300 views.
Yeah.
Like on the whole channel.
So it helps you get a better channel.
Well, not that. And then you can celebrate your small wins and shit like that to tell your people like, hey, look, guys, thank you for helping me with this. Oh, yeah. Like I upgraded. I mean, I passed 110 now. Mm-hmm. 110 subscribers. I'm at 111 right now is where it's at. But yeah.
Well, speaking of my channel. Bought some Pokemon packs today.
I heard you did get a DM, right? Somebody said.
Yep.
Somebody said,
want me to start the channel.
Shout out to the buddy Michael.
Yeah. So we're gonna start a channel up.
Fuck yeah.
I pulled some packs today. I didn't wait. Kenya got it on video, but yeah, Urshifu is like the model Pokemon on the Battle Styles Pokemon packs right now.
Yeah.
I pulled a VMAX today that is worth like $30.
Nice.
Out of a $7 pack. Yeah, I'm pretty stoked about it.
So when it's worth more like that, it can do more damage if you use it. If you use it playing and
shit. I was explaining to you regular side Pokemon and then there's VMAX, which is like gigantic Pokemon, like mega evolutions.
Right.
Sometimes they even change the properties of what they look like.
Right.
Um,
and you have to have certain cards to be able to
fucking do that shit. Yeah, so I had the base card, which is Urshifu V, and then you have to have the V Max, which is the evolution of the big, big one.
Okay.
And they both have solid attacks.
That's crazy, though, that you have to have a certain card. So, like, if you didn't have the other one, you have that big one, you'd have to have that other one to use it first, right? You said?
Yeah, so... I'm finishing them. I've been eating chips the whole fucking time.
Yeah. I'm going to be muting your track a lot. It's all good.
Essentially, you have to have your first evolution, your second evolution, your third evolution. You can only evolve once per turn.
Okay.
And then if your Pokemon gets attack damage, it carries onto your next Pokemon. So if you have minus 30, yes, your Pokemon gets stronger, but it still carries a minus 30.
Okay.
So in this particular one, these ones are a part of a series that are like Rapid Strike, and then the other one is trying to fucking see. It's Rapid Strike, and then the other one, I forget the other name. Well, there's two different strikes. Well, there's different cards in the series.
Right.
I unfortunately didn't get the variant that had the expensive artwork.
Okay.
I've missed two of them already. I've gotten Tyranitars, and I got Urshifus, and I've gotten the other variants. The ones that I'm missing are like worth $180.
Fuck.
$150.
Damn.
So I'm getting there, but I'm not getting there, you know?
Okay.
But I think it would be cool just to complete the set of that series of the card, just to get the three.
Yeah.
All the variants.
Fuck yeah.
So
see, it is kind of like fucking Pops and shit, man.
Yeah.
That's crazy. So there's like different series and all this shit.
Yeah.
That's cool as fuck, man. Yeah. That's dope. Yeah. Like I said, I almost went there since I was like halfway there doing this this photo shoot, and I was right off Grand Alvernon. I was going to go back to Azia. Mm-hmm. We'll grab that Sir Hiss from the Robin Hood.
Yeah.
Because I got Robin Hood. And then after that, I just have to get Prince John.
But then the set will be collect.
Huh? Then the set will be full. And that's a fucking, like, it's an old ass set, bro. It's from 2014.
That's a vaulted.
Yeah, it's definitely vaulted. So I'm going to fucking try to make it out there. Maybe, actually, oh my God, I'm going to be there tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm going to go get it tomorrow. I have a photo shoot at a barbershop over there, kind of by Park Place. One of the homies that got a package off me that gets the website and shit, and it has like the photo shoot involved and fucking little video involved. So like it's like literally like its own whole ready to roll fucking website. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's got a little promo video. It's got all the photos to make it look like a legit ass website, you know? So got to go down there. So I'm going to be right there. Shit, I might as well swoop it up tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay.
Hopefully it's still there. We'll see. If not, might have to pull the trigger on Randy Watson. But okay. Let me see. Where the fuck are we at? Let's put a break in right here.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
Hey, this is Chris.
And I'm the Duchess.
And we're the hashtag No Offense Show.
And you're listening to the Hood Diner
with the homie Casual
and DJ Sentry.
Who?
Ding ding.
Only on the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Peace.
He's all. It even have grown man acting all feminine. Hi. And the fucking.
The ad libs were fucking.
Hi. Yeah, that shit was fucking hilarious. Okay. Let me see where we at. We are in sports, bro. Only thing I wrote down is we got some dude named Tommy Lloyd as our new head coach.
That's a good pickup, bro.
And he said, or he's from, he was an assistant coach at Gonzaga for 20 years.
You know what's fucked up? What's that? Took one of the starters with them.
Oh, I saw that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. What can we say, dude?
Hey, that's a good pickup, bro.
What can we say?
That's a good pickup. That's all I got to say.
That was cute. Today, the homegirl that I did this photo shoot for is her daughter is graduating, so it's a senior portrait. She got a scholarship to ASU.
That's what's up.
So it was cute. She had the color was gold, and then she had an ASU shirt underneath. So I had like a picture of her doing this, like kind of like she's Superman and the fucking, it says Arizona State right there. Just say, came out pretty cool. I'm a fucking Photoshop fucking Arizona on it. Change the colors. Be like, this is where you should have gone. Bet, think I fucking will. I'm going to do it. Just for fucking shits and giggles. What else in sports, dog? How the fucking Suns doing right now?
Balling, bro.
Yeah?
They just beat the 76ers right now.
Okay.
Joel Embiid fucking threw a full court shot to tie the game and it rolled out.
Okay.
They won 116-113.
Nice.
I think they're like 14 of their last 15 they won, I think.
Okay.
They're balling right now.
Fuck yeah. Okay. Tech and news shit.
No, in the NFL, the draft is next week.
Oh yeah, the draft is next week, huh? Dude, I was listening to The Plunge, and one of the homies on there was talking about bets that he's made on the draft. I was like, that's fucking crazy, bro. Like, betting who's going to go where and what number, how many quarterbacks will go in the first round, shit like that. You know what I mean? I was like, damn, dog, that's fucking awesome.
Does he hit on him?
I want to say yes. He sounded like he knew what he was talking about. But, yeah. Anything else in sports?
ASU's been getting fucking crazy amount of fucking transfers from different conferences, man.
Football or basketball?
Basketball.
Basketball, okay.
They got some ballers coming through. Okay. And obviously, you get all the ballers in the fucking world, but if you can't put it together on court, then it's kind of, what are you going to do, you know?
Right.
But, yeah, man. Two of the players transferred out and went to GCU.
GCU?
GCU made the tournament this past tournament.
You're talking about the Grand Canyon University, State University, whatever? Mm-hmm. Okay. They got a pretty nice looking campus. Like, it's right off the freeway when you're heading through Phoenix.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, you can see it and shit. You can see their little fucking, they got a small little football field and shit like that, I think.
Okay.
It's pretty dope. They got a little arena where they play basketball. Doing that shit. That's that online shit. Is that that one where it's like, what are you doing with yourself right now? Yeah, you, sitting on the couch.
Antelopes.
Is that what that, I don't know what it was, but.
No, remember, no, no.
That was that commercial where that dude made you feel like a piece of shit.
The hip-hop version?
Yeah. So what are you doing? What are you doing with your life right now? Get off the couch. We're smoking that shit. Fucking asshole. I remember people used to talk so much shit about that. They're like, dude, I feel like a piece of shit after I watch that commercial.
What are you doing with your life?
Obviously nothing, man.
You're sitting there eating Frosted Flakes in your underwear.
Right?
Fuck.
Oh, man.
I'm there crying, eating cereal. My tears are going out of my milk.
Right. Okay. Second new shit, bro. The Apple event went down yesterday. They finally dropped them shits that I've been talking about. The fucking, called AirTags. You want to know what's funny? One of the first things I saw, the people talking shit where they're like, yeah, stalkers, like the new toy that stalkers are going to love, right? Bro, I saw this thing. It's actually pretty dope. You know what it does? Let's say you thought you were trying to be sneaky and you put one like in your lady's car or shit, right? You know what I'm saying? If there's ever one near them and they have like an Apple, maybe it don't work if you don't have a fucking iPhone. But if you do have an iPhone, the girl will get like a fucking, or your wife will get like a thing saying like, there is an AirTag near you. Is it yours? Or some shit like that. Like, it lets you know that there's a fucking AirTag near you. So it knows, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how it works with Androids and shit.
Yeah.
But for Apple, that's what they said. They're like, oh yeah, no, you can't do that. They're very anti-stalker. Like, they're anti-stalker. No worry about it. No worries. No. This isn't for any of you lose your shit, okay? Lose your shit.
Only.
Only if you lose your shit. You're all fucking, it will find you dead in my stolen backpack.
Jeez.
Oh, shit. Okay. Apple dropped a new iPad Air. I think it's a Pro, like Apple iPad Air, or no, iPad Pro. And we got both sizes. They updated the Apple TV. It's got like a new, really cool looking remote. And like, it's like very intuitive and shit like that. Voice built in, all kinds of crazy shit. And then they also upgraded all the iMacs, and like the iMacs come in like fucking every color imaginable. Like they kind of went back to the old school.
Yeah.
When they had them big round ones and shit like that. They're like the green and the yellow and the red and the blue. You get your iMac in all those colors now and shit. Super thin ass fucking.
Oh, dude, I love it.
They look super sick, dude. So yeah, so they upgraded the iMacs. Oh, and the new iMacs have the thumbprint technology on the keyboard. So nobody can open your shit up except for yourself with your fucking or they cut your finger off. Vin vin vin. No ni mueves, cabroncito.
Jeez.
Es all. Antonio, mira.
Now the leg.
Look what's gonna happen to your friend.
What just happened to you? You gotta give me the money.
Yeah, you're
all. I used to watch that movie religiously.
Now the leg, huh?
I have a fucking DVD right there, a special edition DVD. I think I put it up here.
I used to have it. I sold it.
Sealed, yeah, man. It's like $20 at fucking. I bought it for $50.
I remember when they were $50 at Best Buy. Well, two of
them. Like I said, still got one sealed, but
that's dope. But yeah, fucking yeah. Don't get your finger chopped off, or that you can sign into people's shit. My cousin just texted me. Now he sent me a message before on Facebook, but now it's in text. You want to go see Mortal Kombat? Okay, let me just show you real quick. This shit was on Hypebeast, dude. Some motherfucking, look at this shit. Come on, bitch.
It's the galaxy. An unforgettable hero is about to return. Introducing the world's first auto-converting, interactive, voice-enabled, programmable Autobot hero, Optimus Prime. The Transformers toy that defined a generation comes to life by the command of your voice.
It's all casual. Get off your ass and get to work.
Yeah, right? It's all, stop looking at pops, motherfucker.
The Decepticons want you to waste your time.
Dude, $700 for this motherfucker.
God.
Didn't that seem like it was just a shitload of movements for him to fucking get up and get up, get out and get something?
Yeah, I mean.
Don't spend all your day transforming.
It's tight, but $700 tight? Not so much.
5,000 parts, 60 microchips, 27 servo motors. Hasbro has teamed up with RoboSend to create the world's first Optimus Prime. Standing at 19 inches tall when upright.
Yeah.
I was like, there's the setup, Goose. But, yeah, and he can go right back to the fucking truck. And he can be controlled through 25 of your own voice commands, such as roll out, convert, and attack.
Roll out.
Roll out. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, bum, bum. Yeah. Being prime. Okay. It works with like an app on your phone and. You can do different programs and shit like that, dude. Like, it's pretty sick, bro. It's going to be up on Hasbro's website. I'll put the fucking link in the description so anybody that wants to check it out. But, yeah, I thought that was pretty dope. I was like, dude, we've finally seen the fucking day where we can have a fucking toy that is actually a real Transformer. That's fucking crazy, you know?
Yeah.
And the last thing I have is I thought it was cool, but now I kind of don't. It's this thing. It's called the LST camera. It's a 32 billion pixel space camera that can take the largest single image in the world.
Okay.
3.2 billion pixels, bro. You're wow. Fucking. You're
wow.
You're all wow.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. That's all that gets right there. Wow. Put the link in the description for anybody that's interested in that. Okay. Show love and no love.
Ooh.
I'm showing love to the client, and I am showing love to my wife for grabbing us all these munchies that we enjoyed on the 421 episode today. So yeah, much love to her. Let me see. No love. You know, I don't have a no love this week. I'm all about love right now. I'm all about the show love. So
yeah, show love to Alva for switching with me so I can still get that bag.
Right. There you go. Know
what I'm talking about, and still enjoy a nice evening with my family during that wedding.
Hell yeah.
And then no love to that fucking cocksucker Chauvin. I'm glad they found that cocksucker guilty.
You know, I thought I would have got more likes on my thing too. I had one where I said, they gonna be Chauvin it in his ass when he, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And nobody stepped in.
Hey, you know what?
You didn't either.
Our brand is a little different. A little different. We're a little seasoned, you know? A little more twisted than the circle, apparently.
You're all there's a little more maniaco in your flavor.
Yeah. When God was throwing in the different spices of our personality.
He went overboard on the cochino.
The cochino, he was like a salt shaker that you prank your friend with.
Yeah.
You know, you unscrew the top. And God was like, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit.
And he was all
He dropped a little gruesome Funko Pop in their DNA.
Little Diaka.
Off the Diaka.
But you know what? I'm okay with that. I'm okay with being, that's Century, the pervert.
Okay. You know what? Be you. I'm going to be me. And
Century the Deviant.
Right. It's all good, though, dog.
Talking about poopies and cacas and...
Caca pee pee pooka papas. But yeah, man. You got anything else?
No, man, I'm just excited for this weekend. I really am. I mean, my kid has a soccer game at 11. We might not make it.
Yeah.
I might have to tell her mom, hey.
No, I mean, you got some other shit going on.
And it's not even a soccer game. It's more like a practice.
Yeah. Man, she'll understand, bro.
But
she'll understand.
Yeah, there's a wedding going on, so.
Bro, weddings are... me doing that fucking wedding, bro, and I know I've told you this shit. Like, I've always felt... like I've always wanted to do weddings, but I didn't want to be that big ass dude, like in everybody's way, taking photos and shit. But you know what, bro? Like while I was there and while I was doing it and I was being that guy this Saturday, I didn't give a fuck because you know what? I was there for them. It's their day. It's not about you out there in the back or you in the front fucking row. It's about me getting something that they're going to fucking remember for the rest of their lives. You know what I'm saying?
You're not wrong.
Or at least as long as they're married.
You ain't wrong.
But it felt right, bro. It felt right. And I had a really fucking good time doing it. And I'm definitely going to push for more of these fucking weddings and shit, bro. And I was telling Tommy Will, I was like, hey, dog, we got to get fucking Century in here to do the fucking DJing and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because that was the first thing we thought of when we were like, where are we going to put our bags and shit? I was like, let's go talk to the DJ. And he was cool. He was cool. He let me leave my big ass gimbal there and shit that I didn't even wind up using at all.
Okay.
But I was able to leave it right there by his table. And he was all good with it. He watched it for me. Shout out to Cody, the DJ that was there that night. Shout out to Cody. But yeah, man. Fucking hope y'all enjoyed episode 421 or the 421 episode. Episode 126. We want to thank you guys for tuning in. If this is your first time listening, please consider subscribing. Okay. If you like what you heard, please leave a rating and a review. And if you really, really like what you heard, please consider becoming a Patreon member. There you can get the exclusive content such as all of our Something New reviews, bonus behind-the-scenes footage, and access to exclusive Hood Diner swag you can't get anywhere else. Go to patreon.com/thehooddiner or click the link in the description below. I am Casual520. That's K-A-Z-U-A-L 520.
I'm DJ _Century on all social media platforms.
Together, you can find us at thehooddiner.com. There you get the links to all the socials, the links to all of the sponsors, which are Dude Wipes, Empire Rolling, Sandbox, and Official Clothing. Everything is code Hood. Shout out to the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Go to innercirclepn.com. Get the links to all the shows, which are the hashtag No Offense Show, Simmons and More, The Untrained Eye, Shit Happens When You Party Naked, The Plunge, Failing Hollywood, and the Hood Diner, and also special shows like, you know, the motherfucking Creatures of the Night, and then you got Jason Almy with his fucking new fucking crazy Abu Dhabi cafe shit going on. I'm gonna check them shits out, bro. And also, we finally do have our bumper. So earlier when I took a pee break, that was Jason Almy. He's owed me that for a hot minute. So
finally sent it.
And he finally sent it and shit. He said I might be offended by it. Okay. I don't know. So I'm excited. I'm excited to hear this shit. You know what I'm saying? So we'll see what happens. But yeah, innercirclepn.com. And yeah, man, thehoodniner.com, episode 126. We'll see you guys next week. Peace.
Peace.
Some good ass weed.
Controlled by a handful of men, now the truth can finally be told. The Inner Circle.